occurrences something, but item one started on the 1st of February when the city got a call from a third ward resident complaining about blue stains in their water tub and a blue stain in their laundry. City staff and the engineers met to determine what the possible causes of something like that was, but it was a lone incident, and they were working to see what could possibly cause that if it was related to our system, because from other items as well. There were no additional complaints throughout the week until late in the evening of the 6th of February, and then early on the morning of the 7th of February, when several calls came in about either bluish or brownish water in our homes. And so that, again, the same group was working together to see what was going on. On the 8th of February, that's when things really started heating up a little bit. We got 5 calls from third ward residents. 4 of them that there were blue or green water, and one report that someone was throwing up after they had taken a full glass of water. Just threw up and that was it, but still, it was up. And so the city immediately called DEP on that morning, and together with their guidance, they determined that it was probably, that since this was all isolated in the third ward area, it was probably coming from one or two of the industrial plants that were out there, Franklin Bronze or Franklin Industries. That would make sense. They've got industrial chemical processes that they use, and possibly if it got into the water system. That was the theory that we were working on at the time. Later that day, the staff and the city engineer inspected both plants, they did a thorough inspection. Later on, they determined that it was not plants, that there was no backfill flow of refuse or any kind of water contamination coming back from the plants. However, during the time while they were investigating the plants, with the guidance of DEP, the city issued a do not use the water notice to a targeted area right around where the complaints were coming from and where the plants were located. At that same time, the crisis team that the city pulled together, which I have to say was very impressive while I was watching it, between the fire department, the police, and probably every person on the city hall. I don't know that anybody didn't get pulled into this, but they came up with a free water supply at the fire department, bottled water, as well as buffaloes for non-potable water if somebody wanted it. For those areas, those people from the third ward, they were taken care of with water. If they couldn't come to the fire department, they would be delivered to their homes. The YMCA opened up their showers for anybody. And so that was part of what was going on. Water testing began in that immediate area to see what was going on. At that time, some of the water was coming back, and these were our tests. They were not certified tests that take 2 or 3 days to get the results back from. We were seeing some higher levels of copper and aluminum in those waters, so it really indicated that it would be from these industrial sites. Again, that was during the time when the inspection was still going on. While that was happening, some of the water staff at the Barrett's Flats plant noticed that a pump was malfunctioned, and that was a pump that put a flow of fluoride into the system. It had surprisingly 3 different issues with the pump. All 3 malfunctioned. And so much fluoride was put into the system at that time, which made us think that maybe this is the issue. But we still weren't sure because of the other things that were going on with the plant. of us. So we were working with DEP, all the fluoride plants, we decided, the two pumps that we have, and one in each plant, were cut off completely. We weren't going to add any more fluoride to the system. And then they began flushing the hydrant, the lines, they were opening the fire hydrants and flushing the lines, and continuing to take tests. They expanded the area of testing, and some of the city water tanks were showing some high fluoride levels. So they decided at that point to drop the levels of water in the tanks and replenish it with clean water. That takes time, of course. On the morning of the 9th, after it was determined that it was absolutely not the industrial plants causing the problem, DEP suggested to us that it probably was the fluoride, and that probably caused both the copper and the aluminum issues that we were finding. So since we did start doing the flushing, the testing, and the notification of everybody to turn board, since two of the tanks were citywide tanks, DEP suggested that we notify, or actually the city manager decided to notify the entire community, the entire system that we serve, even though there were never any incidences in any of the testing that we did any place out of this area. There were some in Rocky Grove, mainly Giant Eagle area, some in Oak Hill at the back of the system, and the rest were in the Third Ward area. We tested schools, we tested development center, we tested homes, we tested businesses, and as the days wore on, the tests were coming down. You could see them coming down for the fluoride level. And there was a meeting with DEP on the 14th, and that's when they issued us an order that they even agreed or noted to us that this is what you said you were doing, that you were going to do, flushing the system, doing the inspections, putting out the advisory notices, and all of that. We are now just ordering you to do that. So that was okay. That was their procedure. But they had two issues in the notice of the order. One was that we violated their requirements to notify them within 1 hour of the incident. And my question was, okay, when did the incident happen so that I know how many hours we were late? And they didn't have a clue. So I don't know how we were an hour late if they didn't know when it started. But the issue we had was in no way were we complaining with DEP. We were trying to solve the problem. They were notified as soon as we knew something happened, and we were in the process working with different people in the department. Not always the right person at the right time, I guess. But we take and even at that time, DEP, when they asked us to, or ordered us to send this last notice to everybody and throughout the system, which I was concerned was going to cause confusion, given that people outside of the Third Ward area did not get a letter initially, and it's exactly what happened. People called up to me, people I saw, people other people saw, said, wait a minute, I didn't get the initial area. Does that letter, does that mean it's gotten worse? And it didn't. It did not at all, but they just said because those two tanks showed some fluoride, high levels, that there was a potential that it could have happened, but in none of the testing did it go anywhere outside of the targeted area. And so we had to do that, and we sent them out. I have to thank city response team and basically DEP for the greater amount of it, because we do work together to make sure that we do have healthy, safe drinking water, and that is our paramount goal here. And I know that there's issues about fluoride, there's issues about just safe water in general, and there's issues about safe practices. And one of the things that we will be doing is issuing a report to DEP by the end of the month, by the exactly what happened, when it happened, who was involved, all of that other kind of stuff, all the details that I'm not giving you right here, and what we did about it, and the third part is, what are we going to do to ensure that this doesn't happen again? And that report, I didn't want to give you the details of it. We know a lot of it now, but I didn't want to give you the details because before the 26th, it will be refined, and I don't want to keep you missing information because you will be developing the real plan in the next 2 weeks. But that document is a public document, and as soon as it's available to get to DEP, we will post it, or the city will post it on their website for anybody to look at. Now, I know this has caused a great deal of concern, legitimate concern from a lot of people, and I would like to hear your comments and concerns about a couple of weeks that we've been going through with some of you, and how it's affected you. If anybody who'd like to talk, I'd like to come up to the lectern, give your name and address, and if you would, let me know if you actually had an incident in your house or in your place of work or a business or anything like that.
My name is John S. Stock. I have two addresses, Otter Street and Evergreen Drive. I had no incidents in my home. My concern is with fluoride.
Is that on? I don't know if that's on.
Because my profession, I'm a dentist, okay? And fluoride has proven public health benefits, and it is not the culprit. High concentrations can be dangerous. Now, as a previous member of authority, I can recall that we would get monthly operation reports of water treatment plants on a daily basis that showed chlorine fluoride levels. You still get those. I don't know the details, and you might spell that on your report, but if the incident occurred on the 1st of February and the operations, water operations, were aware of a higher fluoride level for the 8th, that makes me wonder how were they testing for fluoride? If they are, is it flawed? The other problem is if you have a failure in your disinfectant system, chlorine, if you get too much, you can deal with it. If you don't get enough, you can have big time problems. So my issue is, I think there needs to be more oversight as far as the testing, determine what these levels are, so they don't build up to potentially dangerous or not high enough level where they precipitate.
I don't intend to respond to every person.
Okay, I'm not expecting a response, but I just want to.
In what you're suggesting right there, I do want to comment because we will be bringing this up tonight, and probably most of you will leave before we finish our meeting. But we have what's called a SCADA system. It's in operation now in the water department. It's almost done in the sewer department, and it's basically an electronic data system that
it's
self-monitoring, and it's immediate contact notice to various people. And we do not have the fluoride pump connected to that. And what Fred, I think, is going to bring up tonight is connecting that.